There are many men alive in this world today, other than all have died. And I'm thankful to God that I'm still alive. How many of you are alive? Can we raise our hand? Can we say loudly, I'm still alive?
I'm still alive.
I'm still alive.
I'm still alive.
Yes. God has created this universe very beautifully and have given the seed of life. Every living creature is having life of seed inside of them. And when we start our journey, if I talk about that seed, the very first step, it has to die. And the first thing is what it faces: loneliness and the darkness. I'm going to share my story, and trust me, only the voice is mine, the words will be yours, because we are sharing the same kind of story. I was living my life according to time, but dream, certification is the one thing which motivates you to do whatever you want to achieve. In 2014, the thought, that seed I sow, and formed Azels Technologies. Azels means God is my strength. I had everything, planning, strategies, skills. There was only one thing lacking, and that was the capital. I didn't have any capital. I was looking for it. And whatever I could do, I did. Tuitions, trainings, developing websites, whatever I could do, I did. But it was just, I was fulfilling my daily needs. When you start something, when you sow seed, you are very hopeful that it is going to bear fruit, but it has to face a lot of things. Heat, humidity, heavy rainfall, even the parasite attack. And if that seed survives, definitely it grows and bears the fruits. Same thing happened with me. Whatever I planned, it was not working. If day by day life was getting worse, everyone was poking me, what the hell you are doing with your life? But I had dream, because I have to complete it. In every story, there is a girl. And in my life, it was from my school life. Everything was okay. I was going to marry her, but there was two problems. Just like in Bollywood movies, the first, religion. I'm a Christian chap, and she was not. And the second one, that I was jobless. The second problem was not the bigger than the first one. Because religion is a bitter juice. Nobody wants to drink it. But at the end, everything was fine. Both the families was ready to accept me or her, and we are going to be in a relationship, but there was a problem about the religion. But at the end, we was able and successfully married in May 2015. Now I had a lot of responsibilities. In a few days, I was going to attend a lot of functions, and I have to, according to Indian culture, we had to give a lot of giving and taking things. And I was jobless, because I really not wanted to engage myself under anyone, because I'm a dreamer. On that time, new marriage, new relationship, everything is new, and I was completely depressing day by day. At the end, I decided to go for a job. The salary was very less. But still, I had to do. My wife was very happy. Now she can tell my husband is doing this thing. This was a very proud moment for her, but she was knowing that Amit will not carry this for long. This happened. People recognize my potential. People recognize my skills. But when you grow, there is a dirty politics. I know you might have seen it. They tried that I will surrender, but I did not. I quit that job. What should I do now? My seeds was again in a dry firm, in a dry land where it was going to vanish. I don't have any capital, nothing I had. I went to bank, no bank was giving me loan because I don't have anything to show them in the account. So I went to a lady and take unsecured loan from market with a 36% of interest. Set up the office, I chose each and everything from everywhere, set up my system in a very low cost. At a very low cost. And came up. 36% interest was very high. My priority was to give up the loan at the first time. Every month I was just paying the interest only, and the principal amount was still there. It was a huge burden for me. But still, we was moving ahead. I did nice. We was growing. 7 months I carried that loan, and then I took a big loan to give up that entire amount at once. That time I was succeeded. Now I had everything. I paid a remaining amount I was using as a working capital. But again, a hero can't be happy for long, right? In the month of May, my mother got heart stroke. So the working capital was now life-saving capital. In the month of June, my mother healed completely. Seven number is lucky number. How many of you believe? Yeah, you believe in seven number. But this was not lucky for me, because that was the month of July 2017, from the first of day GST introduced in India. And I start losing business because client was not ready to pay 18% tax. It was a very bad thing. I had loan. One of my friends is sitting here, Sudhanshu. For the 3 months, I have not able to pay my rent, my salaries. I was running from everywhere, no EMI. People was chasing me day and night. My father is in army, you understand, every time. He said to me, beta, biryani ke chakkar mein mat raho. Namak roti khao and kush raho. But I had dream, I had to achieve it. I really don't want to be loser. I decided to go because I know that failure is there, but still I was ready to lose things to win in my life. And I did it. We was growing very badly, day and night. At the end, I was frustrated. It doesn't matter that how positive you are, how positive thoughts you do have, how positive you behave, but when negativity is around you, you still behave affecting with that negativity. There was negative people around me, those who were very wise and intelligent, with their stats, with their analyzing things. They were saying, Amit, you cannot survive because working capital is not with you. Every intelligent person was saying to me, you can't. There was only two fool people in my life. One is my wife, second is my mother, who said you can. Who said you can? At night, my wife used to cry when light is off. But I can feel that witness. What the life I was giving to her, what the promises I had to make to her. Because about those promises, those dreams, she married me. It was really shocking for me. I decided to quit my life. There was no sign of anyone that what I'm going to do. I was just behaving like a cold fish. My face was expressionless. My voice was not fumbling. I decided I quit. But before that, I really want to enjoy the dinner. I cook food. Regularly we do praise and worship at our home. I did. I went to my roof, said loudly to Lord, oh Jesus, I can't bear it anymore. I have surrendered. I'm totally relying on you. Please help me out. I was thinking. Then suddenly, the verse of Bible came into my mind. I opened my Bible. It was Isaiah chapter 41. There is written, those who wait upon the Lord, they shall fly like an eagle. A huge wave came from heaven. From my head to nail, each and every part of my body was shaking with that wave. My goosebumps was like porcupine spike. I opened my Bible. A photo of mine fell down from it. It was a very old one. My mother used to keep it. I was weeping, crying. My tears was rolling down and fell on that photo. I picked it up. I was looking very handsome, as I have never seen that before. And I start imagining, Amit, what the hell you was going to do? If you will die, who is going to complete your dream? How you are going to survive? Who will do these things? If you will die, your father and mother both are the heart patient. If your father die, how your sister will survive? If not, then how he is going to do all things alone? That was in my mind. But now Amit, you're dead. I said to my soul loudly, no, I'm still alive. I left that thing immediately. I regained my strength. I wiped the tears, picked my photo and said, no, Amit is still alive. I can't quit. I can't quit. And I was continuously doing that thing. There is a saying. Those who believe a savior will come, those are the person who are like slaves. Slaves wait for someone to rescue them. I said, I'm not a slave. I will rescue my thing. All things are opposite of mine, but I'm with me. I did everything. I did the BD work, marketing work. I went to client and projected myself that what I'm doing. I regained. And with the help of the God, the grace of the God is that in next 9 months, I'm going to repay my complete loan. In today, in your life, there are a lot of problems. It could be the financial, emotional, physical problem. There are a lot of problems. Even your story could be the worst than mine. But I just want to motivate you. You are bigger than your problem. Can we raise our hand and can say, I'm still alive?
Yes.
Say to your problems that you're not bigger than me. I'm going to kill that all. Because I'm still alive.
I'm still alive.
Can you say loudly, I'm still alive?
I'm still alive.
I do have faith.
I do have faith.
And my faith is bigger than problem.
My faith is bigger than my problem.
Because I'm still alive.
I'm still alive.
Thank you. Over to
Thank
you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you so much.